Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and give a warm welcome to Karan, Casey, Niamh, and Sean.
Y'all, thank you for coming out of a Tuesday night. Thank you. I think I know nearly everyone here. It's like my wedding. Thank you.
Loving with all of her might, her baby.
Sean, up there on the sound, you're doing a fantastic job. It sounds great, doesn't it?
We love Sean. Yes. We love him.
The easiest sound check on the tour so far by like about 10 million miles. Thank you. Well, I'm delighted to be here and I'm delighted to be traveling with this pair. They're just absolutely fantastic. This is the wonderful Niamh Dunne on the fiddles and vocals. And Sean O'Graham on the guitars and vocals.
Trees fall.
I made a new album. It's called Nine Apples of Gold, and you heard a few of the tracks from it there. And this is another one. It's called Sister, I Am Here For You. It's very easy to sing along to this chorus. It's Sister, I Am Here For You. Sister, I Am Here For You. Sister, I Am Here For You. And I'm listening to. It's the sisterhood out Woo-hoo! Tonight. Yes. Travel with you no matter what they say. We're stronger than the rocks in the sea. As wise as the birds in the tree. And if things don't go as planned, thank you. fantastic, Niamh Dunne.
Thanks. I'm going to very quickly, do you mind standing up just for a second? You see that for a t-shirt? Oh! So we have these very t-shirts for sale tonight saying, "Sister, I am here for you." And I mean, you look great. You look fantastic. Okay, so buy the t-shirts so that the band can have dinner. Okay, thank you.
Well, I'm going to dedicate this next song. I know that there's a lot of people in the audience tonight who were very good friends with a really good friend of mine, Doherty Buchanan, who she passed away in January, and I had known her for 30 years. I met her 30 years ago in New York, across the road, actually, in Scholastic. I was a waitress and I was a nanny. Like all your wonderful emigrants. Let's hear it for the emigrants.
Yes, yes.
And I managed somehow to get a job in Scholastic because I think, the boss woman, she liked my Irish accent because I definitely don't have any expertise in children's science books. And I was like, oh, geez, I think I'm just after getting this job because of my Irish accent. And Dorothy said, don't worry, you'll do fine. And she was an extraordinary woman. It was brilliant to have her in our lives. I know there's Eamon and Alex and Sam here. And she, you know, it was quite a corporate environment, but she managed to persuade people that she'd work for 7 months of the year and then she'd take 5 months off. And they were like, of course, Dorothy, whatever.
Yes.
And she was really brilliant for social justice. She went to Guatemala, Puerto Rico to build houses. She marched across Germany, had a vigil drumming outside Auschwitz and Ravensburg. And she was in Garvahy Road in the north of Ireland. She invited me actually up there for holidays 1 year. And she was really just brilliant and a gift to us all. She was an educator and she was a storyteller and a poet and an amazing woman. And I got to sit Shiva for the first time out in Queens, which was really beautiful. And I was really glad that I was here. And it is kind of like an Irish wake without the drink. Yes, it was great. It was really beautiful. And she was very, very funny. Like towards the end of her life, she had a million books in her flat, and she was asking me, would I try and, you know, arrange them a bit better? And I was sitting in her room. I was actually crying, and I was looking at all the books. And then I heard her pick up the phone, and she said, "Well, I have terminal cancer. How are you today, young man?"
Sorry, I thought that was really funny.
So, this is for Dorothy. It's called "I Live in a Country," and she was very supportive of me singing my political songs. This song ambitiously tries to tell Irish history in a 4 minutes flat. And it's all about women, and I know things are rough here in America, but keep fighting and keep working for your reproductive rights. I live in a country, I am the tongue, I am her tongue. I have one smooth tongue and I have one rough tongue. I am here and I am listening. I am the small, roundy ear that has heard it all. Ooh. We are the daughters of the witches that you could not burn for centuries. Daughters of the Magdalene laundries when you had us down upon our knees. Daughters of the mother and baby homes when you did what you pleased. Ooh. Ooh. patient and kind, and reserve the right to lose my mind. Tired of being patient and wise, whilst viewing my demise. Some days I want revenge, but most I fight for equality. Ireland is an empire of misogyny. Fuck the patriarchy, fuck the patriarchy. I live in a country where we long to be free. I live in a country where I want to be me. I live in a country where we long to be free. I live in a country. I want to be me. To be me,
a believer.
I am stone, I am sea, I am wind, I am river, mountain and rock, I'm salt in the sea, gorse and I'm at you, blazing back at you, grazing as you to be me, but the patriarchy, but the patriarchy. I want to be me, but the patriarchy, but the patriarchy. All together now. I want to be me, but the patriarchy, but the patriarchy. I want to be me, but the patriarchy. Okay, how are you in singing form? Yes, great. Do you know the King Shillin by any chance? Yes. For those who don't, the chorus is "Come laddies, come, take." Oh Jesus, what is the chorus? "Come laddies, come, hear the cannons roar. Take the King's shilling, and you're off to war." I've only been singing it for 25 years. It really is fantastic to be back in New York. Yes. I'm even looking forward to the train going under.
For King and country, we will fight today. sound of guns. I love it, it's flashed in the morning sun. Does it beat out the cannons roared? And the shilling didn't seem, oh, the shilling didn't seem much worth the war. Come, laddies, come, hear the cannons roar. Take the king's shilling and you're off to war. Well, the men they fought and the men did fall. Cut down by bayonet and musket bomb. Many of these brave young men would never fight for, they'd never fight for the king again. Come, laddies, come, hear the cannons roar. Take the king's shilling and you die in war. Come, laddies, come, hear the cannons roar. Take the king's shilling and you die in war. Come, laddies, come.
Well, we're going to do a song I wrote for my mother, Anne Casey was her name. Were ye all here the last time I was here? Yeah. Do you want to hear the same story again? Okay, great. So I was explaining to everyone that my dad is a character, and my mother, been married to him for so long, she's passed away now, but she can only be described as a saint, like an absolute saint. And he loves to sing, my dad. He's a fantastic singer, actually. And he has loads of parties. And but my husband, Niall Vallely, Lottie, you know Niall, he was having a record launch in, I think, probably 1997, when there were records and record launches and record shops and record money. Yes. And it was up in Dublin, you know, it was a big deal, and his parents were coming, and I wanted to make a good impression. And Niall had his gig, and it was, all went very well. And then my dad took to the bar and sang Danny Boy about 17 times. After about 2 hours, then myself and my mother were at the other side of the room. And my mother said, go over there and tell your father to put back on his fucking shirt. And he was showing everybody his heart operation scars. I know, as you do. Okay. Thank you for laughing, because I know you've heard that before.
A lullaby, a lullaby.
Thank you. Well, aren't I blessed? Aren't they incredible? Yes. So I wanted to invite you all to Ireland. I'm doing this bus tour in October. And please come on over. Yes? Yeah, do. You're all more than welcome. And the idea is that, you know, we'll be singing songs, and my husband Niall will be on it as well. He'll be playing tunes. And there's a session every night, or a concert. And we're going from Ennis in County Clare, and then we'll be going to the Cliffs of Moher, Hag's Head, Limerick City. And, Niamh is from Limerick. And then we're going on up to Sligo and across to Derry and over to Belfast and down to Dublin. And I've invited loads of characters. You know, Ireland is full of characters. People who talk about a rock in the middle of a field really beautifully and poetically for quite a long time. And there'll be great food and lovely beds and historians, Liz Gillis and Dr. Mary McAuliffe. And Bernadette Devlin, will be doing a few hours. So, you know, I've tried to line up people that I want to go to, actually, to be really honest. So if you'd like to come, I'll have a mailing list outside and I can chat to you afterwards. Okay. That's my pitch for the night.
Would sell my rack, oh, I would sell
Thank you, folks. I dedicate that to Fiona and Helen over there. So what you do, I said that I'm an Irish singer, and he went, uh-huh, sad songs.
I was like, yes. what are we doing? Oh, will I tell him the story? Oh, Jesus, we'd be here all night. Okay. So I suppose I've been trying to write the women back into the narrative. I was invited up to Dublin into the song tradition to sing, and for the commemoration of the rebellion, and I could only find three songs about the women. And in Ireland, in this amazing song tradition that we have, you know, which is kind of like a parallel narrative to the establishment, you know, we can sing often what we cannot say. And actually, in fact, that's what one man told me in the middle of nowhere, that really I should just sing and not talk. I think he didn't like my politics. Another one said, really, you should go home to Ireland and sort out the problems between the Protestants and Catholics. So I did that. Here we are. So, but anyway, I digress. Kathleen Clark was this amazing woman that I really learnt about only very recently. My own great-grandmother, I didn't know, was involved in Limerick in the rebellion. Limerick, there's a lot of Limerick tonight. And when I was trying to research her, I couldn't find out a lot about her, but I found this memoir about Kathleen Clark. And she was a piano player, and she wanted really passionately to be a piano player. But her uncle James, who had returned from Australia to run the family business because her father had died, you can tell this is going to be a really long story. he said, no way, you're not going to be a piano player. You'll never make any money. So James was correct about that. And she started her own business, and she was a seamstress. And she did really, really well. And then her uncle, John Daly, was in prison in England for years. And with him was Tom Clark, who was the first president of the Irish Republic. I know I'm talking to the converted here. But he came back out of jail, and he'd been treated terribly in jail. He was in solitary confinement for most of his 15 years. And he stayed to kind of recuperate in their house, and they fell in love. And but Kathleen's family were not happy. They didn't want her to marry. He was older than her, and he had no job, and he was, from jail. So she said, no, I am marrying him, and she defied them, and they sailed to America, and she brought her money from her seamstress business, and she was going from Penn Station up to Yonkers, and she left all her money on the train. I know. So then they moved to New Jersey. Yes, everybody laughs, actually, at that bit. And they had three sons, and then they returned home to Ireland and were very instrumental in the rebellion. Kathleen was the only woman to know all the details, and Tom was executed by the Empire, as was her younger brother, Ned. But she continued on in political life, and she fought the cause, particularly for women and for Irish freedom. So she's just amazing. I thought she deserved a song.
I will rise.
drumming too loud.
The energy levels good. I have to do my Auntie Una August Auntie Maura story, my aunt's. The latest story is, you know the one about during halftime Auntie Maura said, "Do you think that the second half will be as long as the first?" And then the new one is we were at a gig and we're saying, "How are the energy levels? Would you like one or two more songs?" And Auntie Una said, "Just do the one." So I want to tell you a little story. When I was 18, I was I got a job in Mallorca, and I went off singing my first real sort of singing gig. I was delighted with myself, and I only lasted about a week. I got fired because I was doing too many jazz songs. I love jazz. I was supposed to be doing sort of pop. I kind of had lied, actually, and said I'd do pop, but then when I got there, I wanted to sing jazz. Anyway, I said, what'll I do myself? And I had a cassette of Sting. I don't know if any of you will remember. He made a beautiful cassette with the King's Band in Morocco. They're an amazing band of Moroccan musicians. And I thought, sure, look, I'll go to Morocco and I'll listen. Yeah, find them. And off I went over on the ferry and down across the mountains. And I was in Marrakesh, beautiful Medina there, delighted with myself. It was so spectacular, the spices and smells and aromas and colours. But of course, it was like 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the day, and I had no hat. I know. So I got really bad sunstroke, and then I threw myself into a taxi and got to the hostel, and the man behind the desk put me into the bed, and then every few hours he would come in and he'd rub what smelled like curry on my head. And he minded me like for, I'd say, three days. I was very sick. And then I kind of staggered out of the bed and I saw him praying on his mat in the morning light. And that is my Muslim brother. That is the man I am remembering in this deep time of trouble as a profound human being who looked after me when he didn't have to. And so I really want to us all to remember that and call for an immediate and permanent ceasefire in Palestine. Thank you. Thank you. So this is the weeping time.
promise flew on wings yesterday. My friend Grady did say, how you getting along like a song on the Amtrak ramble through Georgia. Tired dirt roads of Georgia, keep the memory of the weeping time alive. Memory of the weeping time alive. We resist, we assist, we resist, we persist. Keep the memory of the weeping time alive. From the cradle to the grave, in the home of the brave, every road we hold. Toil and work all day, river marks the waterway, the Altima River of Georgia. Birds, they circle and wheel in formation on the Butler plantation. The memory of the weeping time alive. Memory of the weeping time alive. We resist, we assist, we resist, we persist. Keep the memory of the weeping time alive. Time steps onto the train. Time with her dominant refrain. How many drowned, how many survived, how many were caught again? If the waters could weep, if the dawn could speak. The color, the ways they're all down here. Old oak, Spanish moss, and turtles and gators. We sing the memory of the color. She comes out into the night sky. She is all shimmering and shy. She lays herself down to cry. Of the weeping time alive. We resist, we assist, we resist, we persist. Keep the memory of the weeping time alive. Keep the memory of the weeping time alive. Memory of the weeping time alive.
To do a beautiful old sad song. It's the Rocks of Bawn, gorgeous. And I'd love if you could all sing along. Normally people sing the end. You know all that, don't you?
Yes, good.
So we've been in the States for how long? A week, week and a half?
A year.
And we're having a fantastic time meeting everyone. And we're going now tomorrow to Ohio. So if you know anyone in Ohio, please tell them we're coming. And then we're going to Mountain Stage to Charleston. Yes, to celebrate Tim O'Brien's birthday. Yeah, and then I'm going to Virginia Beach to sing with the Virginia Symphony Orchestra. So that should be very nice. I better wash my dress. Yes. And I'll sing this for Warren and Abigail if they're here. They've been putting us up for the past few days and minding us, and we really appreciate it. Thank you. Okay.
Shoes they are well.
Oh yeah, the fantastic Sean O'Graham, Niamh Dunne. Thank you so much, Sean, up there on the sound.
Thank you.
Jean Anne on the lights.
Thanks, Jean Anne.
And Lama, thank you for looking after us so well, and everyone here in Joe's Pub. Thank you. Give yourselves a round of applause. We're going to leave you with a song called Man of God, and hopefully we'll see you soon. I didn't realise it was so late. Okay, thank you all for coming out. Thank you. Thank you. No problem. Actually, I want to sing this for Bob Donnelly. I think he's here, who's another fantastic friend of mine for years, and he always has my back. Is that you down there, Bob? Yes, thank you.
of a man.